Hello, my name is Karen Stevenson and I'm number two cello with the Philharmonia Orchestra. I'd like to introduce you to my cello. The body of the cello is made of wood, normally maple or spruce. At the top here we have the scroll and then four pegs which hold in place the four metal strings, which are A, the highest, D, G and C, the thickest string at the bottom, and they reduce in thickness to the top string. Now these four strings are drawn down the cello and over the wooden bridge and then into the tailpiece at the end. And at the bottom we have the spike which anchors us to the floor. We tune the strings with the four pegs and also with four tiny adjusters on the tailpiece as well. To make a sound, we can do two things. We can use the finger, which is plucking or pizzicato, or we can use the bow, we can do an attack to make it sound more exciting. We can do short notes or long notes and everything you can imagine in between. So we have the four open strings of the cello. But that wouldn't be very interesting if we only played those. So we need to use our left hand. The cello has an enormous range, and it's been said that it's most typical of the range of the human voice. I love the role that the cello has in the orchestra because we can play the bass lines, we can be the driving force along with the double basses, underpinning everything in the orchestra. But also, as a cellist, we get given glorious melodies to play as well. We get to play everything on the cello, so we're always kept very busy. Thank you. I'd now like to talk about vibrato. Here is a note without vibrato. Have a look at my left hand. Without vibrato, my left hand is very still. Vibrato is a way we colour the sound, and we rotate the fingers like this. And you can make different sounds. You can do a fast vibrato, very passionate, or you could do a very quiet poco vibrato. Here is an example of a well-known piece for cello, but I'm going to play it without vibrato first. It's The Swan by Saint-Saëns. Not very interesting, so here it is with some vibrato. Next, I'd like to talk about pizzicato, which is plucking the string with the finger. We can use double stops, which is playing two or more strings at the same time. A very famous example of this is the opening of Elgar's Cello Concerto. Another technique is using harmonics. This is where you touch the string with the left hand, but you don't press down. This part of the bow is called the frog, or the heel, and we can use it to play very aggressively. This is the point of the bow, and we can do something called tremolando with that, which is when we move the bow very quickly, right at the tip. There are many brilliant things you can do on the cello, too many to list here, but here are some of my favourites. The first is an impression of seagulls. A really cool thing you can do on the cello is cello twirling, which looks great when you do it in a section, and you can even do a Mexican wave of cello twirling. Thank you.